Hello, everyone, and welcome to another segment of FF Insider. I'm here with Krista, and we're really excited to talk about co-creation, our FPO program, and some recent events that we've had going on. So, Krista, can you tell us a little bit about the co-creation event that we had at our 919 Futurist Day?
Sure. During 919 Day, we invited over 70 users here to our facility to help co-create with us. And what does that actually mean? It's the ideation of future products and features with FF Insiders or FF employees, along with our user environment. So we invited them here. We gave them a tour of our facility. We gave them a deep dive into the vehicle and access to the vehicle. And then we also brought in competitor vehicles and had them compare our prototype with those vehicles in order to figure out where do we want to go in the future? What features are we missing? What do they like on the other cars that maybe we should bring into ours into the future? And this is the idea of taking what's already out there and taking what we've currently developed and then taking it the next step. So we wanted to hear direct feedback, and that is the essence of the FPO program, or the Futurist Product Officer program, where I can talk to customers and get direct feedback on what do you want to see in vehicles. And this was our first event we did, and it was spectacular.
Very cool. What was the overall sentiment based off of their feedback?
The overall sentiment is we're doing really well in the area of technology. We're really taking things to the next step. We are doing things that other OEMs aren't doing. There are certain things where we have a prototype, and so we will be bringing those levels of fit and finish up. But overall, we are rocking it, and we are getting ready for production.
Well, that's awesome. What kinds of vehicles were there to benchmark or compare against?
So we decided to take three iconic brands that are the peak of technology, performance, and luxury. So we brought in a Rolls-Royce Cullinan, a Lamborghini Urus, and a Mercedes-Benz Maybach in order to compare features.
And these users, how was the interaction? Were they just standing outside of the cars, or did they really get to get a feel for what the experience would be?
Yep, so we had product experts stationed at each one of the vehicles to point out the highlights of those vehicles, and then also to bring in where the FF91 may be bringing out either advanced technologies or maybe where we can consider technologies in the future. So we really allowed the users to experience both sets, ours and theirs, in order to give us a clear, unbiased feedback as much as possible. I'm interested in learning how can we do better and what can we bring to the market that's not already there. And the best idea is to learn from those that are already there and doing well.
Well, this was a bit of a workshop, right? There was some participation involved. And how was that? What did the users get to do and what did that look like for them?
So we had three rotations. We introduced them to our IOV technology through a demonstration, gave them a tour and a presentation of our design studio. We also then did the rotations around the vehicles, our powertrain system, as well as had designers there for them to draw out their ideas. And so with that, we gave them also feedback forms in which they could help or provide direct feedback to us. And we got hundreds of lines of data in which we are now taking a look at and seeing what we can bring to our product definition team and see where we can go.
That's awesome. It sounds like this is not just a project that involves one team, but it's going to expand into the larger, the grand scheme of things as we put FF91 into production.
Absolutely. This is the idea of bringing the company to the users. Typically what happens in traditional OEMs is the product is created maybe with a closed focus group, very localized processes in terms of one or two sessions, but we're trying to bring FF directly to the users on all levels. So we're getting company participation, because the idea is if we can build vehicles that the users need, want, and maybe they can't even imagine yet, that's really how we're gonna thrive in the marketplace.
Yeah, well, going a little bit outside of focused groups, we've also been bringing FF91 out to local events here in Southern California. Most recently, we brought it to the LA County Sheriff Car Show that they did with Purist Group, which was really cool because we got to see people who weren't ready to see the car, right? Like they weren't expecting it to be there, but the reactions that we got were awesome. We even had the sheriff himself. He got in the car. He was like, I think I need one for my fleet. And he really enjoyed it. And it's cool to see these genuine reactions of people who have no idea what they're about to get themselves into.
That's the best part. And the 919 event was our first FPO event like this, a co-creation event, but I'm very excited to do these in the future. It really reminds you of what is special about launching a car, and that's having those experiences, seeing the reaction, it's intoxicating. So I'm excited to keep doing this and to get this car into people's hands, let them experience it, let them drive it, and then also collect their feedback in order to make it even better in the future.
What would be the best way if someone wanted to join the FPO program and start getting their hands-on experience with FF91? How could they do that?
They can actually download the FF app from their app store, so Google Play or the Apple app store. Once you download the app, within the home screen, there's the sign-up page for the FPO program. It's a quick sign-up. We just need a couple of details in order to continue to have conversations with you. But other than that, we will get you signed up and we will then start the conversation. And we welcome anybody to join at this point because all feedback is good feedback. This isn't a one-time focus group type of program. I want to start a conversation and a relationship with my users.
That's great. And what kinds of things can they look forward to when they join FPO?
So we should be having within the app or online experience voting opportunities. Tell us, what do you want to see? Do you like this color or that wheel? We're developing those type of questions as well as possible sweepstakes. Maybe you can earn a hat or something. As well as these in-person events. And those are going to be very special because it'll be the first events before production will be the first time the cars are really being seen by the customers and also through these local events. So,
how has it been working with the FPO program and what's your favorite part of this program?
My favorite part of the program is that direct interaction with users and to really build the relationship with them. I've experienced market research and, like I mentioned before, focus groups before, and it's really one and done. This is really, tell me your feedback today, let me see what I can do, and let's continue the conversation. If you think of something or if you want to see something, let's have that talk. It's not a one-time email, it's not just a one-time event, but it's let's develop the relationship, and that's the most exciting part, is this is something to last, and then maybe, you know, you never know. In our next product, you might see something where you said, hey, I asked for it, and they made it happen.
That's great. We love it. Well, Krista, thank you so much for joining us today. We really appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
Of course. And thank you all so much for watching this segment of FF Insider. If you haven't already, make sure you download the FF Intelligent app available on iOS and Android. There you can interact with us and join the FPO program to chat with Krista and her team. We've been really excited to come out with these segments, so we'll catch you next Monday on FF Insider.